for decades, computing became more and more expensive and complex. For 40s, 50s, 60s, IBM, one single company, dominated 90% of profitability in computers. And in one single event happened in 1975, PC got invented and barrier to entry went from millions of dollars to thousands of dollars. And as a result of that, many new people could come and play and create solutions that fundamentally change computing. Yahoo, Google, so on and so forth, Facebook, Apple. What is the equivalent of that in public services? What we need to do is bring the barrier to entry down, liberate it, allow many people to come with many solutions, not try to pick the winners, but create the context. And I think in that environment, entrepreneurialism, new ideas, disruptive innovations will flourish. Britain in public services needs to do what Silicon Valley did in technology, what Victorian England did in Industrial Revolution. We can do that. We've done it in the past. Ask yourself, why is a tiny island like Britain is among the world leaders in retail, in banking, in professional services? It's because when those things came and telecommunication revolutions came, we overhauled those industries faster than other countries. And as a result, we were in a better sector. Do we do that with our education, with our health, with our public services today? It's our choice, and the government shouldn't withdraw from that choice.